Welcome back from that break. Now, for any entrepreneur, making your first sale could leave you very thrilled because that could mean that your business is headed for growth. But what happens after just 1 week of success and everything is so stagnant, but you have to meet costs within your business? This is the story of Director Kibajo Jinja found himself in after he made several sales in the first 2 weeks, but later on had a dry spell for months without any revenues coming in. The trick for him, however, was persistence and patience. How to make money?
We've not made the break even because we are 8 months old.
Okay.
Yeah, but we are making sales. The turnaround has been very interesting.
Okay.
Because you know that customers mostly in today's world they buy packaging.
That's right.
Yes. So 70% of my customers buy because of the packaging.
It but looks the quality must be good as
at
well.
At first, some of them,
yeah,
they tell me, no, I bought your product because it was looking, you know, very nice. But do you know what is surprising and amazing? When I took it home, it is still now the best product because there's no ginger I've tested, yeah, which is pure. And even after using it for months, yeah, the purity does not decrease.
As a business person, where do you project the business now in terms of supply? Because, I mean, look, you've moved into a very good production, yeah, as packaging, what is the word? Packaging material.
Yeah.
And you're moving into finding UNBS.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Once you have the UNBS mark, mm-hmm, what are the prospects of the business? Where do you see yourself moving forward?
Oh, there's a line which is exciting. I usually tell people,
yes,
I'm not building a small business. Me, I'm building Kibajo as a leading ginger East African brand.
Yeah.
So that in East Africa, someone, when he talks about ginger, it's Kibajo which comes first.
Okay.
And with this, now after achieving the UN-based certification,
yeah,
we are going to be in every big supermarket. We are going to be in every big supermarket so that when you are in Kampala, you are in Masaka, you are in Gulu, because now we are limited to the supermarket market, to the market for those big supermarkets, because we don't have the certification. After certification, which is in process, we are going to take the product in there. Because like I told you, those imported ginger, which is not even pure, like this same 200 gram would be at 18,000. This is just 12. And this is 100% pure, no additives, no preservatives. It's indigenous. It can preserve itself.
Okay. So there's a lot of excitement that encompasses a young man or a young woman trying to start a business.
Mm-hmm.
What are some of the disciplines, or how disciplined have you been to ensure that you stay focused on the business, don't get carried away by the small monies the business is making immediately,
yeah,
and ensure that moving forward you want to see this East African brand achieved?
It's pure and an exciting journey. My biggest attributing factor,
yeah,
is consistency, coupled with the availability, like being able to start.
Yeah,
it's the first one. You should be able to start. As the saying, which is out there, that the most interesting ideas are, you find them in the graveyard, because the people need to start. So the first one is starting.
Yes.
And after starting, just, you know, entrepreneurship is a very challenging journey, but pays off in the long run.
Yeah.
And you need to be very consistent. Sometimes, let me give you a live example. I sold, I made over 1 million sales in my first 2 weeks of starting. That is very difficult. Even if you ask those big entrepreneurs out there, people even spend a month without making 2 sales when they start their idea.
Yeah.
Me, I made over 1 million sales in the first 2 weeks. And but let me tell you something exciting. After making that money for the first 2 weeks, I spent more 2 weeks without making any sale.
How did you feel?
It was letting a bit down. But because I believed in this idea,
yeah,
I remained consistent.
Mm.
I kept posting on my social media platforms and informing everyone every day. I'm very, very positive, and I have that energy of daily positivity.
Yeah.
So being positive daily if I've made sales, if I've faced challenges or not, and being consistent. If you meet me today and you meet me after 365 days, that's 1 year, yeah, you will see me with the same enthusiasm, the same energy, and the same positivity. So you should be having that positivity every day. Challenges are there, but you focus on that vision where you want to see this product going.
Okay.
Focus there. So when you focus there that you are building a brand, or you are building that best product, or the best organization, or the best enterprise or company, then you'll be looking at the end. So these challenges will be there, but people will be even seeing you smiling. Like, what is happening with this guy?
I understand. So as a business person, almost everyone your age that is starting up a business talks about money,
yeah,
finance. I know for a fact that you are lucky that you had the raw materials,
yeah.
growing up, and you still have them already. So there's not much that you invested in gene growing and all that.
Yeah.
But has there been a process, I mean, a scenario where you've thought about looking for maybe a loan from the bank to support your business, or you have been the type that has said, you know what, I have to go slow, go small until I can break even without taking a loan from the bank? And if so, why did you choose to do that?
I chose to start small without looking for any funding in my first 8 months of operation. It was a decision from the start because I knew looking for this money would bring two challenges. One, I can get trapped into looking for the money and the idea is not working. Two, I knew that if I keep looking for money, I'll concentrate on looking for money and the idea is here not moving very well. And also, these people want to give grants or to give loans. They want impact, something which has been validated, that has been working, making sales. So I was like, I'm going to make sales, make the shouting, every kind of shouting out there on social media, everywhere. So that in the ecosystem, when people talk about Jinja, they bring Chibajo. People start referring to Chibajo. And now I'll be looking for the money to do the expansion. Because currently we are also looking for money to do the solar dryers, everything. But we are not looking for the money that we are not moving on. First, we are moving on. Even if I don't receive money in the coming 2 years, I'm going to be moving on and I'll be successful. So I decided to start small and get the sales and the savings from the team members, and we push this forward because now I told you we have impact. There are people who have been in operation for 5 years and they don't have the impact we are having. Already 30 women, some of them are widows, single mothers. Whenever we are going to be doing the post-harvest management, they get income from us. You get the point? So with just even less than a year, we are able to impact lives. So I decided to start small, but also looking, I'm not looking much for loans currently. I can look for maybe, they call them impact loans,
yeah,
which don't have high interest, yes, like those ones which have 20%, that's too big for a startup.
Yeah.
Because a startup has a lot of running costs and a lot of pivoting, changing directions. So you need to get a loan with high interest when you've reached up there. So when you are still at baby steps, it's better to use the savings, to use from the contributions from the teams, from the sales, to push. And if you can get kind of grant for CD funding, if you have an opportunity. But for me, I decided not to get lost in making applications, looking for money. I got lost in building the brand. When you go out there today and you're looking for Jinja, even online, people are like, hey, Chibajo, there is a Chibajo, Chibajo somewhere.
So how did you end up? What he's saying is your story starts from some village in Butambala.
Yes.
And now you're up here in Muyenga, in this place. Why are you here?
As I've told you, that my enthusiasm never stopped. Sometimes I sit on different panels and people don't even accept that I've not gone to the university.
Yeah.
I've gotten international nominations. For example, last year I was a Mandela Fellow. It's a prestigious fellowship for incredible, like the best young African leaders. It was started by Barack Obama, and it was even now awarded by the current president of the US. Yeah, from the US. And now I'm playing a lot of roles in the ecosystem. like trying to coordinate the entrepreneurs. So now I'm here also working with Zest and Rising as also a digital manager and also an entrepreneurs coordinator. You know, coordinate with the entrepreneurs and trying to connect with them, the opportunities, getting what the challenges they go through. So when I talk about entrepreneurship, for me it's from the practical point of view, not from the theoretical point of view. I've lived the life of an entrepreneur from as early as 20 years. Like practically when I'm trying to create solutions up to today when I'm 26. So 6 years I'm directly in the ecosystem. And here I've got a lot of experience now. I know what entrepreneurs go through at different stages, the needs the support they need from the incubators, ecosystem builders. Here.
Thank you.
Now, this week in part two of our personal finance with Johnny Baptist Yahweh, team leader, business banking, Standard Chartered Bank, we look at the relevance of individual budgeting.
I'll start on the individual perspective where some of the things that you need to take care of in terms of your budgeting. One, there should be an opening line on your budget for balance brought forward in the previous months or month. It could be a negative balance or positive balance. If you're the one living in debt, then you have a negative balance most likely. But worry not, there's always a starting point. Then put in the income. Look at your salary, if your salary earner, if it's income from business, include your income. If you have rental income, please indicate it. If you have any other investments, include the what is coming through there. Take note of your expenditures in there. There should be food, fuel, rent, if you're renting. It could be renting for the business where it is, or even including your home. Take care of the school fees, health, clothing. Put some money for entertainment, probably dinners, donations and tithe if you're a believer, and then the balance. I'll give a bit of an estimate to try to attach some of the percentages to your income. We encourage that at least 10% of your income should be in savings, whether a salary earner or you have run your own businesses. Probably 10% on food, housing 20%, transport and entertainment 10%. Somebody will say, why 10% with all these high skyrocketing fuel prices? I'll mention there are many alternative means of transport. If you have been driving your car to office and you realize that your 10% is exceeded, then it's high time you look for alternatives. Probably you try public means. It doesn't hurt. Where possible, you can walk. It's, after all, it's healthy. And ultimately, make sure you're living within your budget. Then we talk of school fees. Take your children to the schools that you can afford sustainably, not because your neighbor is taking them to a high-end school. Take them where you can afford. Of course, this education is not necessarily linked to school fees paid. There are decent schools within our locations, our localities, that really are taking care of our children at a reasonable price which you can afford. Take time and invest in identifying those schools, as opposed to simply taking kids to schools because others are taking them to other schools. There are many times when you see parents crossing from one side of town into another, purely to drop kids and then come back to another side. You're already spending too much in fuel on top of the transport. Yet within your own locality, there should be schools, but identify them and support those schools to become better so that they give the type of education that your kids should have. Medical should take 10%. Many times we don't invest in medical and we shun away the issues of insurance. And when things backfire, many times we find ourselves spending too much extremely. But think of it, health insurances have come up with different packages. Whether you're an employee of a given company, you can do a medical scheme, or at a company level, business level, or individual level, you can always work arrangements and sign up for some medical insurance schemes that are relevant to your income.
The Uganda shilling stood steadily against the dollar, with the corporate demand matching together with healthy inflows and interbank sellers and month-end inflows which started trickling in. Here now is the Forex and Money Market Report. come to the end of the show, but as a business person, always strive to be different every day and also have a heart to change the negatives whenever they are pointed out by your customers than sending them away, because that is not how you make money. We meet again. Until then, have a good night.